Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will color in my Tim Jeffs book. This was my favorite book for a long time. It's filled with lovely grayscale images of animals and I've colored a lot in this book. So a very quick flip. Let me turn this one to give you some idea. This is without a color, and this is with a color, and yeah, I want to color a picture today, and it is this one. Let me move my tea, otherwise I will knock it over. I have to make some more room on my desk. I choose this one to color. I have not much left in the book, only 8 pages I think. This beautiful sea turtle, and for a long time I wanted to finish it and I still didn't finish it, so I was thinking maybe it's fun to color this one on video and try out some of my unused art supplies. I picked out some of the colors already from my Derwent watercolors. I have the old ones, the Rexall ones, with a lot of pigment. And yeah, let's see. I didn't sharpen them yet, so maybe I have to remove just the outer layer. Let's do it with all of them. I know not many people. I think I must say, like the Derwent watercolors. I don't know, I haven't used them, so let's see. It will be the first time, so I will start with a layer of the raw umber. And I will go over the shaded areas of the page. Tim Jeffs is a wonderful artist. I'm really enjoying coloring those pages. When I first started coloring one of his pages, it took me a lot of time to color. I really took my time with it and I made sure that all my shading was perfect, and now it is more a relaxing way of coloring and yeah, a lot faster. I know now that the shading is really forgiven and yeah. If you put down your pigment right, you will be okay. And after a layer of watercolor, you always can deepen your colors with regular colors and color pencils. I always can go on top with the artist or yeah. I have colored some of the pages before with Albrecht Dürer pencils and polygons on top. So I know it will be okay to do a watercolor base first and see how I like the result and move on from there. I will start wetting this one already, then it can dry, and when we move on with this we can start layering here. I first want to look up the animal. Let me. It's an ocelot. So we simply can Google it. I didn't know, but yeah, I think I will be fine with the colors that I picked. It's easier to first pick your colors, to look the picture up before you pick your colors. Yeah. Now I just activate the watercolors. If there is too much pigment, you can pick it back up with your brush. And the inside of the ears are more pinky tone, and I picked out an orangey for my display, so I hope I will be fine with the color of my choice. So we will see. If you add your pigment in the light colors and you want to make them back white again, you always can add in the Prismacolor white pencil, this one, and get back your highlights. And it's perfectly doable with watercolor pencils. You can easily go on top. Try not to leave harsh lights. Blend it out nicely so that you can create a smooth look. Okay. I think it has some dark inside of all those spots. So first I will get the base down and then color the inside of the spots with an extra layer of number 33. I don't know, some of the colors got numbers and some only got names and numbers and some get only the numbers, so not sure what name is connected to the number. I don't know if the new watercolor pencils are working the same. I hear a lot of people saying that they don't like Derwent watercolor pencils, so maybe they are less pigmented than the older ones. So far I like the color on the page. I like the way they dissolve very well. So not that pigmented as their signature range. Sorry. Yeah, I have to sneeze again. Yeah. Let me add in some of this color and activate it and see how I like it. I will remove the pigment. I think it is easier just to first activate the base layer and then go on top with the darker color. Otherwise, I can see the pigment is going outside of the lines. I'm a messy colorist with this technique, so yeah. Let's speed the process up a little bit. You can see the grayscale on the page is very helpful to create a beautiful result of the picture without a lot of effort. It's a really quick way to color and relaxed way to color. The paper in the first book by Tim Jeffs is different than in the other parts. It got more pages. This one has 50 different images and the other books only got 25. This paper is very nice and thick paper. And in the other part, it is very thin paper. With the thin paper, you still can use watercolor and create some very nice effects. The pages will be buckling, but they are also single-sided, so no problem there. I don't know if this one will be a large spot or that it will be just a part of the leg. I think it is a spot like this part. I have to sharpen a pencil. You also can color those images monochrome, like this one. Just one color and one highlight, accent color. Also one color. Yeah, I'm a huge fan of the book. You can use some crazy colors, like pink or purple animals, and still get a nice result. Sometimes I like to use the realistic colors of the animals. Create another nice result. Make sure you color in the way of the fur. If we get trouble with dissolving the pigment for some reason, you at least didn't create some strange lines the other way around, so it will still matching the coloring page. So let's start with the watercolor, and I go very quickly. It's okay to go over the black lines with the watercolor. You always can go over the lines again with black pencil. or even with fineliner to make it nice dark again if you like. I had to get the water flow going again. Nice blending it together. For watercoloring pages, I let just time go by and let them dry. I know some people really like to speed up the process with some art heating gun, I think it's called, and dry it a lot quicker. You can also use a hair dryer if you like. I don't own any of them, so I use time. I'm already lightening the page. I think I can use more pigment. So I definitely will add in more pencil on top of the watercolor, I think. And because I'm using the Derwent watercolors, I think I will pick out the artist range. Let me get off some of the pigment. I think I'm liking this. Time to add the darker color 33 in the spots of the oxalate. You also can choose just to base it with one color and add the rest in with regular color pencils. Now I am adding the dark watercolor, but you perfectly can let it dry and yeah, add in those differences with the regular pencils. To make sure your page is dry, you can feel it by touch. If it is cold, then you know it is still wet. That little trick I learned from Didi, and I'm sure you all know Didi. She's amazing. She does a lot of streaming and not that much of coloring anymore. But someday she is coloring and I like to learn from her. Let's try and activate. All the spots. And I won't remove the pigment from the brush. Think it's okay if it gets darker. I think I've activated all the spots now. Let's go back to the face. I picked out the Pale Vermilion number 13, so I don't know if this will be the right color. I added in the ears. And I will add it in the nose. So, I think it's way too orangey, but we could tone it down with a color pencil. It will be fine in the end. Okay, I think I like it so far. I will try to find my artist pencils, I think. First have a look. My color swatches, if I can find the right colors. And I think I can find the right colors. So I will be okay. Yes, or maybe Chroma Flow. Those can work too. No, I go with a different artist. One moment, let me grab them. I hope I pick out the right box. I think I have them. Let me check if this is the right box of pencils. Yes, I've also the old ones, the Rexel artist box. So let me get to the ground and pick out the colors I like to use, the raw umber. It's here, Van Dyck Brown. Oh, this is not this raw sienna, I don't know. I'm happy that I'm cutting it early. This one, some for the nose. Let me get the light and the rust. And this one. Then I want some cream colors for the eyes. Chartreuse with the olive cream. Yes. Let me find it in the other tray. Maybe some copper also. So I think I picked out enough. Let me move the box out of the way and the watercolors also. And then take a sip of my tea. I have a nice herbal tea today, cream tea with some cranberry, and it's very Delicious. Then it's time to sharpen some of the pencils. You can see I've used some already, but not all my colors. So. This one is okay. And in the meanwhile, my coloring page is drying, so it's okay to take my time. Yes, I hope the sharpener don't make too much noise. I think I will start with the nose first and with the eyes, but yeah, let me finish off my teeth first. So, the eyes, a light layer of the chartreuse. And then off screen on top. I think it is perfect. Good enough. Now I want to make sure that everything is dry. I will draw in with Posca some white hairs as the last finishing touch. I'm sure those colors are light rust and rust are in the new set also. You can try it with the regular artist and watercolor pencils. I don't think they changed up the numbers. Only the pigments inside are different. The binder is different than the old ones. So, yeah. Light layer of the raw umber on top where I like it. I choose the shading areas to add another layer like here and then go around this spot and leave this one the way it is. Move up. And you can flick in every hair if you like. Today I'm not feeling it to draw every single hair. I want some quicker results today. And you really can see it come alive now, I think. try to avoid the black while you're coloring with your regular color pencils. It will dull it down a lot. With watercolors I don't mind, but with regular color pencils, I don't like it that much. And I'm slowly building my colors this way. I like to add Van Dyck brown, I think, or do I want more red? I will try the Van Dyck brown first in the spots and see how I like it. I think the color is perfect. Or do I like the copper beach more? I think I like the Van Dyck brown more, so let's try to erase it carefully. Try to don't touch the black lines. You will dull it down. Sometimes I like it to try it on a spot like this, on the bottom, so you won't see it as much as a spot on the back, if this makes sense. I'm losing my words again, and I don't know what to talk about, and I'm enjoying my coloring time. I'm recording this on a Friday, and yeah, it's weekend soon, and the boys will be home in half an hour, I think, and so I'm enjoying those last quiet minutes. I'm making a video for you all, and yeah, having some coloring time. Lately I am enjoying my coloring more again. I had some struggles I think with my coloring in March. I was not able to find all those coloring hours. I had so much ideas of coloring, and I was not able to color. I felt very inspired to color, and it was just not happening for me. So I'm really hoping that I'm able to color more this month, April, so we will see at the end of the month. But for now I am enjoying myself, and I don't think I want to add more of the dark brown spots on the legs. I think I will leave it this way. And I will add in more of the pigment. I will call color with the flow of the hair, if I think about it. I think it will be more pretty if you do. It's fun to be back in this book. I think I have only 8 pages left to color before it is complete. And it is on my list to complete one day. So on my books I want to complete. And I haven't colored in it for almost a year. So it's good that I'm back. Me. Yeah, I also want to add more. I'm not sure if there is more white in this animal in real life, but I like him, what I'm doing, so I will just keep going. So my animal has less white, I think. It's okay. You can see how quick it is. I am just coloring for like 30, maybe 40 minutes. And yeah, I think the page is almost complete. You can really complete a page like this in an hour, maybe 1.5 hours. And it's amazing. And still have a great result. I know there are some pages that I was coloring for hours and hours in this book. And looking back at them, I don't know why I spent that much time. But it's okay. On the leg, I only will add the colors on the shaded areas for this part. Now I have to bring back all the black. I will do it off camera. It will take a long time to redraw all the spots. I think it's okay now. I like this highlight, so I will leave it here. And I also like the highlight I created on the leg here. So the tail. I will show you a little of the black I will bring back in. So if you also want to do it, you know how to. But yeah. This part out of frame. I will. Add it back in. Let me find the black pencil. And I think it is on the last tray of the pencil case. Ivory black, I think it will work. Just go over the spots. You can clearly see the difference, so. You don't have to do it if you don't like. If you don't mind the pencil on top of the black. I will go with little hairlines to make it more realistic and not that. Yeah. Blocked in. You can see. I will add it in everywhere. I want to show you how I add in the white hairs. Well, I think I will first try it with the Prismacolor white. And if I don't like the result enough, I will switch over to Posca. Then I have to find my Posca. I don't know where it is. So. Just go with the flow of the book, and I think I like this enough. It is not very harsh. The pencil point snapped. I think it's okay. I like it this way. I have to use my Posca for the eye. I want to make a very nice glow. I have a Posca in here. I want to. For the background, you can leave it this way. I always like to add in some stars. And I combine some bigger stars with smaller stars. And I randomly pop them. You can create some glow around the stars with a Prismacolor pencil. Very big one. You can use multiple colors if you like. You can add some golden stars or just leave it white. You can add a lot of stars or just a few. I had a question about the shine I add around the star, so I will show you. I simply pick my Prismacolor and I draw a circle around it. And not everywhere, a few. And you can also make a shooting star if you like by creating this line around. And then I like to add also the glow around the little star, and that's it. That's everything that I do to create those glowing stars. So I'm done with it. Not too much. Will I finish it on camera? All the little black parts. I have some time left, so maybe I will keep going. Maybe you will enjoy it. And if you don't enjoy it, you can skip the rest of the video. Thank you for watching then, and I hope to see you next time, and I will keep going a little while. for this weekend, we don't have any plans. We will see what the days will bring. Hubby has to work, so most of the time I'm alone with the boys. I don't mind. So I think we will have a relaxed weekend. Maybe I can get some good portion of coloring done. That would be nice. Maybe we can watch some movies together or play some board games. We will see. I like to cook sometimes with the boys in the kitchen and prepare some nice dinner. And have some quality time by, yeah, making the dinner together. That's a great possibility to do this weekend. And create some special dinner for hubby when he's home and after his long day of work, and yeah, can be fun. Not sure yet, we will see. A lot of options to do. I don't know if you really can see the difference on the camera, so let me take a look. Oh yeah, you can see the difference, I think. I think it is funny that this video won't be online on Friday, but maybe on Monday or Wednesday. And I'm talking about the weekend, so please let me know what you have done last weekend, because the weekend will be gone already when you are watching this. How was your weekend? What did you do? And what did you do? Oh my. What have you done? Sometimes my English. Oh. I think I already did those. And you basically can keep going and adding more layers and I think I will add in some extra colors also in the spots, but I think I want to add in the burnt umber, just in the darker part of the yeah, I like it. Also, add it here. Let's remember to go with the hair flow. And then add in extra black around here. The face, I didn't do a lot and I'm really liking the outcome of the face. Not that happy with this part of it. Not this, not the face, but the neck of the animal. And I don't know, maybe it needs some extra colors, some shading colors. Not sure. I'm always keep adding and adding and coloring and see some room to improve, and sometimes you just need to stop where you think it's okay. Brighten it up a little bit. No, don't go out of the line. Yeah, I'm happy with the result so far, so I think I will leave it this way. Otherwise, I will keep going and coloring and tweaking, and I know I can color it in a little bit. Oh, this one. Yeah. A little bit more blending. You can see I can keep coloring and coloring, and I will just end it and think it's done. I like the result. I'm happy with it. I hope you also enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!